We are ready for the great trek, just packing. This is the rear. Loaded up all the most of the stuff on the roof rack, and still have to load the back. The trailer. And there's the kitchen. Still to load all the gear in the trailer and the kitchen. Sorting out all the maps, where to go. Little boxes of knickknacks. This is the library. Video camera goes in the old Esky. Clothing bag. And there's the fridge. Been kept cool for the last few days. The whiskey. Bed linen. Some of our gadget. There's this little bag Mary's just sewed up. Put the cups in so they don't rattle to pieces in the scrubby. And Mary with the loss of voice. A few running repairs to the sleeping bag in case we strike some cold water and cold air temperatures in Queensland.
You get the smoke, watch for the smoke.
Okay!
Sending our email to the rest of Ace and the world. Our first night on the road in Dubbo.
Will you come and learn how to bleed this
diesel? Okay.
Pull that bugger away.
It's our night at Theodore, a community run hotel. Hotel motel at Theodore. We're taking a short cut across country on a road that's not actually the highway up to Rockhampton.
There's our first mayo tree.
This is the bastards. Banana. Heading off for our first swim. Say good morning. This is our campsite, our first setup of the tent, etc. There you go. There's Kelly. This is where Kelly and Jan are staying for a couple of weeks before we head off up to Cape York. That's the way back to Kelly and Jan, where we'll have dinner.
Cameras all over Australia.
Who's that?
That's WA.
Well, they said it's Cedar Bay. Basically, I don't know. They said it's Cedar Bay one.
Hi.
Wow, that's all right.
That's going to be good luck.
Yeah.
This is America. The 10-cent piece, and it's the White House. Isn't it amazing?
way the aunties help look after the babies.
Tell them about the bloke and the big fish yesterday.
Yes, we just met a fellow here who said that a little bit late, because yesterday they caught a 24-kilogram trevally, which is quite a description, is about 4 or 5 feet long. And they used live bait, he got it actually got knocked up here on the wall. But unfortunately, this fellow here was fishing clean here most of the day and caught nothing. But there's quite a strong southeasterly blowing, probably about 18 or 20 knots, making the water a little bit unclear. But it's still quite blue. So thanks, ladies. Helen and Mary, you're supposed to join in that conversation.
Well, I thought you were doing such awfully well. I didn't like to interrupt.
Owners just recently died the other day and was buried, I think, on the caravan park. He spent a while in Changi in the Burma Railway and retired up here and built the caravan park. Hello.
Hi, darling. You duck, night duck.
Here we are in the placid waters. Placid Waters Caravan Park. And Kelly and Jan's two vans, they're transferring gear at the moment into the hire van, which is a four-wheel drive, to go to Cape York.
And that layout, which you could do it, yeah. And they absolutely go anywhere. And Jan and I, we've been looking for one. We nearly bought one.
Yeah.
What's the best seller?
And this is the long-lost book that we've been searching for.
Yeah, that's right.
For ages.
That Bill managed to bury in his bonus bag. Now, why would you keep a book in a bag containing swimmers?
Well, to look after
only
it.
If you're Bill, would you
That's
do
right.
that? Do you want to have a look inside, Bill?
We might wait for the sun to come out a bit more.
Okay.
Yeah,
right.
I think.
Nothing else you want to see, do you?
Beautiful sunny day. Lovely day to set off for the Cape.
Yep.
I'm really getting tired of packing and I'm ready to go.
Where's the phone?
Oh, there's, could you pass it to me, please?
In this little bag, in this little foam bed.
No,
we're probably... Oh, come on.
Okay, Bill, I'm departing the new one. Watch me. This for you. In there?
Ruined the shot, Bill. We've got to get back in again.
Okay. Yes, wonderful. Yes. Okay, Judy.
Bye, Jen.
Thanks. Bye. I can see a cupboard that's not shut.
Good.
Chicken
head. Then
we got to be still. Bill.
Yeah, you got to grin at it.
Okay. Hi, guys. Hurry up. Yes.
Yeah, checking with the stock breaker, Bill.
This one of the tyres.
45 in the front and 45 in the back.
This is our campsite at Placid Waters. We just phoned that Terry and Helen, they're on their way past, we think. I'm feeling tired after a couple of hours of non-sleep last night from the traffic. So we moved down to this spot next to the river at number 148 as opposed to number 16. There's a camper just across the track from us. Looks like it's been up to the Cape. This is the bushwalkers and the serious campers area down here. This is just around the bend where we're camped, just to the left of the camera. Some of our aggressive neighbours, this one's eating full food. There's Trinity Beach. We just had lunch up here. And stop next to the developments. Pretty clean. Mm-hmm. Yeah. There you go, nice view for the pink house. And it just rusted through and we didn't find out until we took the sump off because I went. Well, here we are at Cooktown at last after driving till up past 12 this morning, having cups of tea with Terry and Helen at the caravan park. We're just going down to check over the Endeavour before it sets sail on the high tide.
Just to like for short distances and to carry maximum amount of coal. So that's it. Yeah, they just slap the deck down. That's why it's 8 foot down there and only 4 foot seven through here.
For how long?
You start for 3 months and then from there they just
sort of have a
long. Oh, how do you do?
Terry. Steward,
he looks after as well.
What do you do for toilet facilities?
Toilet facilities? Well, you probably came in early.
Were you one of the first?
Okay. The people who came in early, yeah. They had toilets that were off the bow, mm-hmm. called the seats of ease. Just two little holes. The other seats of ease.
Quietly.
There were two little holes either side, like one on the port, one on the starboard side of the bow, and yeah, that was their toilet. Yeah.
Down here.
where we came out of.
That's good. Yeah.
That may be something I might be able to look at. Absolutely.
Yeah.
So did I think I got the flash.
Going on. I go back every day later.
Folks still there?
My dad is, and his whole family, and part of my mom's family. They've started moving to Colorado now. I have a cousin that lives in Sydney, and so he told me to come out and see him, but I couldn't just stay in Sydney for 2 weeks, so I decided to do this trip. And
oh.